Dear students, today we are going to see about computer-aided biopharmaceutical characterization, that is for gastrointestinal absorption simulation. It is a part of chapter 4. It is a second part of computer-aided drug delivery system, chapter number 4. In gastrointestinal absorption simulation, today we are going to see about introduction, theoretical background, model construction, parameter sensitivity analysis. These are the things we will see now this presentation. The next presentation will contain virtual trial, feed versus fasted state, in vitro dissolution, in vitro in vivo correlation, and bioweaver considerations. This chapter introduces the concept of gastrointestinal absorption simulation using in silico methodology. Parameters for model construction and the sensitivity predicted pharmacokinetic responses to various input parameters are described. That we used to call it as in virtual trials for in silico modeling of drug disposition, or we used to call drug absorption or presentant. The influence of food or without food or fasted state conditions will be done. No, like the followed by the last part, which is in bioweaver consideration, we'll see followed by the next one. No, like important keywords for this lecture is in gastrointestinal absorption, in silico modeling, parameter sensitivity analysis, very, very important, virtual trials, food effects, in vitro in vivo correlation, and bioweavers. Coming to the introduction, a growing concern for biopharmaceutical characterization of drug or pharmaceutical product increased in interest in development and evaluation of in silico tool capable of identifying critical factors. That's what it means about there are many kind of factors are available. But as a pharmaceutics technical people, we need to know about drugs physicochemical properties. Drug dosage form factors are important, which we can able to say like input parameter, we can able to modify, depends upon the response observation. Then influencing in vivo performance, that's what last class also I told you. There is an input parameter, in vitro evaluation, ex vivo evaluation, and pharmacokinetic model. The last one is in clinical data, that interpretation of the results to predict whether it is in drug behavior or model behavior or suitability of the model or utilization of the model can be performed by correlating not only one set of data. That means only physicochemical parameter, only the dosage factors, or you can say like genetic factors, whether you say for in vitro release kinetics, or if you say pharmacokinetic models, and we used to say for ex vivo models, or if you say for in vitro cell line models, then, or maybe final step, we used to get a clinical data from the treatments during phase 4 setup. What we are getting data from clinical observed data, that all together, which will give you very clear insight whether the feasibility or the characters of drug or excipient or the product things can be able to interpret by an explained tool by using an in silico model. That's what it is very, very important to know about the input factors. That factors may be multiple. That's what we need to know. Coming to the drug absorption from GIT is a complex interplay between large number of factors. No, like generally says anything will be disintegrated. No, we need to understand. No, drug physicochemical properties. Second one is in physiological factors. Third one is in formulation related factors. Coming to here, that GI tract physiology in view of drug transit, dissolution and absorption. Among these are advanced dissolution absorption metabolism model, or the GRAS model, or GAT transit model, and the CAT model, or advanced CAT model, or explained still now by using a in silico modeling systems. The commercially available, no, most famous, we can say like Gastro Plus, SimSip, PKSim, that many softwares are available, like PK, Coli, then IntelliFarm, Noris et al. They have been identified. Ciprotex, then IntelliFarm also, again, they made a lot of software packages available to predict the in silico models of drug absorptions. Coming to the theoretical background, the simulation software packages such as GastroPlus PM or advanced technology computer program designed to predict pharmacokinetic and optionally pharmacodynamic effect of the drug in humans and certain animals. We used to call preclinical as well as the clinical study, no, can able to simulate by using a GastroPlus. The underlying model GastroPlus is an ACAT model. ACAT model is in human GI tract. Figure consists of 9 compartments linked to the series, each of them representing a different segment of GI tract. No, one is in stomach, duodenum, 2 jejunum, 3 ileum, and cecum and ascending colon. There is a 9 compartment things are available sequentially. The every food material or any metal which undergo GAT transit. During that period, there are many factors are involved. All are not same. All the properties are not same, even though they are interconnected with the single column. No, that's why it is very, very complex, the things. It starts from, what you can say, pH dependent and time dependent and the by microbial which is available in the GAT also may be dependent. No, that's why to predict the drug absorption characters, we need to have very clear idea. Most common sense we used to say the intention of the drug and the utilization of the drug should be given very specific for specific usage of drug in GIT. Coming to the theoretical background, these compartments are further subdivided comprising of the amount of unreleased drug, the amount of undissolved drug, and dissolved drug, and absorbed drug. No, like we used to call like ADME, in another term we used to call it as an BCS classification, biopharmaceutical classification of drugs, whether it is soluble and permeable. Then we used to have other parameters also, many parameters also involved. Coming to C here, that's what it is say here. One is stomach, duodenum, jejunum 1, jejunum 2, ileum 1, 2, 3, 4, last one is in colon. In terms of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, there are, as I told you, 9 compartments are available. Out of these, we divided into 3 factors. One is an unreleased, undissolved, and dissolved. These are the 3 factors are involved to enter into the erythrocytes. Then it will be coming to the blood system, which will undergo first pass metabolism. This is a very basic thing you need to understand. Again, I'm telling you stomach, duodenum, jejunum, ileum, and colon. No, these compartments, like we have an unreleased components of a drug in each column, then undissolved drugs within each column, then dissolved in each column, then it enters into the portal vein or blood circulation, which is nothing is happened here. If it is undissolved, undigested, it will come into the excretion model. That's what we can say. Simple example I want to show for preparation. In general, the rate of change of dissolved drug concentration in each GI compartment depends upon 10 processes. No, that's what a transient into transit of drug into the compartment, transit of drug out of the compartment, release of the drug from the formulation into a compartment, the dissolution of drug particles, precipitation of drug, luminal degradation of the drug, absorption of drug into the enterocytes, the absorption of drug from the enterocytes back into the lumen, absorption of drug into portal vein via paracellular pathway, and absorption of drug from portal vein via paracellular pathway. These are the simple concept which can be able to understand the GI process compartment depends upon 10 processes. No, transit of drug, release of drug, dissolution of the drug, precipitation of the drug, luminal degradation of the drug, absorption of the drug in enterocyte, absorption of enterocyte, absorption of portal vein, absorption of portal vein. These are the 10 steps. Coming to the oral drug absorption complex process, consists of multiple steps, that is drug disintegration. Any drug when input into it should be dissolved, it should be disintegrated, then it should be soluble, then it should, if anything happens, it is undergo degradation, then it comes through the gastric emptying, intestinal transit, intestinal permeation and transport, and intestinal metabolism and hepatic metabolism. The time scale associated with each of these processes is set by an adequate rate constant. That's what we used to call transfer rate constant. K into T. K is the rate constant. T is the time that associated with the lumen transmit is determined from mean time, or we used to call mean transit time within the each compartment. Now, GIT, no, like if we say stomach 2 hours, then intestine we used to call 3 hours, means 1.2 pH, 5.8, 6.4 pH, it is around 3 hours. Then alkaline 7.4, 7.8 pH, it is around 3 hours. Total we calculate minimum any kind of material which is available in GIT will be considered for 8 hours. 1.2, 6.8 or 6.4 and 7.4 or 7.8. No, even still more also, there is not the issue, but the time consumable is 2 hours, 3 hours, 3 hours is generally considered. The dissolution rate constant is for each comp. The absorption rate constant depends upon the effective permeability multiple by absorption scale factor of each compartment. Once the drug passes through the basolateral membrane of erythrocytes, it reaches portal vein and liver, where it can undergo first pass metabolism. That's as I told you by the figure. From the liver goes into the systemic circulation, where ACAT model is connected in either conventional pharmacokinetic model or physiological basic in deposition model. The PBPK is an additional feature included in more recent versions of GastroPlus-TM. The model construction is a data collection, parameters of optimization, and you have to validate the model. The model exploration, like a parameter sensitivity analysis, very, very important. Next part, we'll be seeing these now. Then the deconvolution to make how, what happens to sink condition, non-sink condition, solubility character, or to compare, we used to call it as an in vivo dissolution comparative profile data. Now it is very, very important. Then we used to call IVIC, no, in vitro in vivo correlation. No, whether you, even you can say there are many things are there I want to talk, like in vitro dissolution study, in vitro permeation study, perfusion studies. Then we used to call it as the XYO study. Then we used to call it as in cell line models, CaCO2 models, cell line models, basically. Then we used to call say XYO models. Then we used to call pharmacokinetic model. Then we say for phase 1, 2, 3, 4 as per the clinical studies. All things we can make it into consideration to get a biorelevant dissolution consideration. The different dosing regimens of also That's what we can able virtual trial. Now we can able to get the data from prediction to observe. That's what we used to call it as an prediction. The prediction can be done even with food or feed and phosphorus. It also can be obtained because all the data may not be the same. All the drugs will not behave the same way. That's why you need to know about all these prediction to predict exactly how the drug undergoes the ADM. Come here, there are steps involved, factor of drug absorption, as we told. There are many factors or complex things are involved. We can say is oral drug administration, age factors, then pharmacokinetic factors. Then we used to say drug degradation factor, then drug permeation through intestinal membrane. Then we used to call it as binders or receptors, which is important. Then portal vein, we used to call transporters, many transporters, P450 or blood flow, protein binding, ACBST. This we have seen all the things, liminal efflux, transporters also very, very important. Then coming to the hepatic, we used to have again, there are many transporters are involved. Then finally, it comes to the drug into the systemic circulation. There are many factors, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Now, many steps are involved. Now, controlling this with the input factors to predict is very tough. Even you can say like in vitro model, in vitro cell line model, XYO model, or clinical also. Like we can say like whether you are doing it for the treatment, phase one study, phase two study, phase three study. But each data gives you a different kind of understanding. Then you can able to reinterpret the results to understand the characters. Then it will be better to know more and more understanding of behavior of drug. It is so complex one. You can say simple paracetamol. No, people says that. When people after doing 100 years, 200 years also, people are inventing new observations. No, that's why it is cellular level or empirical level also. It is important to understand to simulate the mathematical models into biological systems. The mechanistic approach to predicting oral absorption is in mechanical approach, quasi-equilibrium model, steady-state model, dynamic model, dispersion model. When you compare to compartment model, CAT model, compartment absorption and transit, ACAT model, advanced compartment absorption transit model, GRAS model, then GA transit model, GGETA model, the ADAM model, that advanced dissolution absorption metabolism models. GASTO plus ACAT model is model required number of input parameters which should be adequate reflect biopharmaceutical properties. That's what no need to think about too much. It is a mathematical tool people have developed. Then you can, by using this, by using a software, by simply we can be able to do it as like we do for DOE. There is an input parameter, there is an response parameter. That's not very simple. Like transit time, pH, volume, length, corresponding to the GV is a population mean obtained from. But this data, what happened? This complete 3-4 data, we can able to do it with a different population. Like what I can say, like healthy volunteer or pediatric, geriatric, or if you see pregnant woman, that group of population for the same study, for same data can be obtained. That's why it gives you very nice, predictions, which will be able to obtain very easily. No, the solubility of the drug, what happens, permeability, log P, the parameters, what we can able to see, diffusion coefficient, these are things we used to do. Then again, if you say pharmacokinetic parameter, clearance, volume of distribution, percentage of drug extracted in oral cavity, gut or liver can be obtained. No, like the gastroplus. Certain formulation characteristics like particle size, distribution density, dissolution profile for control release formulation. Given known solubility of any single pH can be obtained. That's what we can say like by using a Henderson-Hasselbalch reaction can be able to relate. Coming to mechanistic models, like as we discussed earlier, quasi steady state, the dispersion model, then compartment oral absorption of the drug can be highly soluble. ACAT model developed based on the CAD model, including first-pass metabolism of colon absorption. This model includes linear transfer of kinetic, non-linear metabolism of transport kinetics, six states of the component, that is unreleased, undissolved, dissolved, degraded, metabolized, and absorbed. No, like what we have seen here, example, I could be able to show this. No, here we have seen only 1, 2, 3 model. No, with the column. Then if you could be able to increase many number with the group, no, then we can able to get more data. Then we can use the mathematical model. No, that's what it says about here. Like nonlinear metabolism, transport kinetics of six states of component. That what we have seen earlier is a three-component system, three states of the drug: unreleased drug, undissolved drug, dissolved drug, degraded, metabolized, and absorbed. Nine compartment like stomach, seven segments of small intestine. That is common. No, like we can able to see three state of excreted material. Then Gross model, the physiologically based multiple compartment model was developed predicted. Oral drug absorption. This model describes fluid movement, emptying and transit, which represents particularly for time dependent flux, which is the stomach duodenum transit to the, which is specifically for solubility permeability in tissue surface area. Then if, when I come to GITA model, it was originally proposed to predict an oral drug absorptions in rats because of possible convenient to conduct in situ closed loop environmental in animals, like XIO study could be able to do better than the human. That's why this model GI transit absorption, and that advanced dissolution absorption model, which is for the processes of dissolution, trend, gut wall permeation, drug degradation, intestinal metabolism, and active transport also can be obtained. No, that's what it says about this model construction. Coming to the model modeling, like we can say, like as we discussed, that mechanistic models is a parameter input output. That's what we can able to do by using the same thing. We can able to read this. There is no much thing depending upon the objective of the study. As I discussed earlier, that human animal physiological faucet wearable simulation, the group of things can be obtained. No? Case one study, that GI simulation of nemocyte oral absorption is an interesting example on how selection of input data might influence model accuracy to predict drug pharmacokinetic profile. The scientists have been research published one in 2012. The drug specific absorption model were constructed in two independent analysts using the same set of in vivo data, but the with a different presumption regarding the key factors govern nemocyte absorption. No, that model one people said about like parameters. No, the parametric analysis also I'll see same thing, like molecular weight, log PD, PKA, jejunal permeability, dose milligram, dose volume, solubility, like mean precipitation time and diffusion coefficient, drug particle density, drug particle density, the effective particle radius, body weight, and first pass excretion in the liver. You can say 1.8, 1.48. Then it is almost molecular weight. This you cannot change. That's why it is common value. This is a common value for theoretical value. Same data. These are the model one and model two. 1.8, 1.4, 2.25. 2.20 into 10 to the power minus 4. Point, this is very, very less compared to this 0.3. Then this data is only diffusion coefficient they have done in one model. Then effective particle radius they have done in one and another model we could be able to see. These data are obtained to get an input parameter of GIT simulation. By the above models, the constructed assuming that nemocyte might be substrate of for influx transporters in intestine. Therefore, that ASF were adjusted to the best matching results in to the in vivo observed data. Experimentally, the intrinsic solubility was used as an input value. The human jejunal permeability was in silico model was predicted. The drug particle radius was assumed to be 5 micron. All other parameters are fixed at default, represent the human Foston physiology. There are, you can see, like I can say by reading this, like inflex intestine, then we use to say in vivo data, they say best fit, then they say input value of jejunum permeability, then we can say like assume for 5 micron parameters are fostered in physiology. In here, how you can interpret the data, that's what it is very important. Just by reading you may not understand. One factor is a very, very critical, very, very simple way they given intrinsic solubility. I think so your people know, the pharmacist should know what is meant by intrinsic solubility, the solubility of a pure drug. No, that is very important. When you are giving as a formulation or different dosage form, what is a comparative data? When comparative data of NIMS line in intestine with the pure drug and with the formulation have been done. That's what it gives you here. Then it gives you in vitro in vivo correlation data. Then it gives you exactly what happens into the input value in jejunum permeability. They have considered only jejunal permeability. They have not considered other things. Then how much amount of radius of that particular jejunum was available. Then particle sizes they mentioned for particle radius of assumed is drug particle is in 5 micron. The 5 micron size of NIMS line when compared to the pure drug solubility and the formulation in terms of specific human jejunum permeability, then it has been compared with the data of in vitro release as well as in vivo data, then we can able to obtain exactly what happened to the NIMS slide with a different set of data. We can able to say this is like this. No, it goes like this, like that, and then we can able to predict. Based on the comparative data, if you say same thing, they have done in immediate release, absorption initial concentration for IR suspension, they are compared to, no? Here you can say they have done with a pure drug with the formulation. Here they have done with immediate release tablet as well as the suspension. No? That's what it says about model 2, NIMS slide well absorbed in oral, mainly pH surfactant induced increasing solubility of GI milieu. No, that's what it says about. This is says very wholesome, like AUC record. This is very specific record, which is same NIMS slide also with formulation with an pure drug. That's what we used to call intrinsic solubility. Here you can say like first one is in comparison is model 1. Model 1 is what we can say pure intrinsic solubility. Predicted model 2 is in product, that observed one is in dotted, we are getting randomly, then we used to call it as an thread line to be obtained. Almost similar we are getting predicted models. That's what we used to say. Here, if you say second model, they have done in vitro, in vivo, that model 1 dissolved, model one absorbed. Model 1 dissolved absorbed is, model 2 absorbed is, then immediate release is given better than, we can say like a suspension. That's what it says about. This is a suspension data. This is a immediate release data. That immediate release with respect to the time, it reaches peak, suspensions are small. Then you can say, conclude that immediate release formulations are better than suspensions. Here you can say, like there is no much difference between intrinsic as well as the formulation. There is no much difference by using the prediction. That's what it says. Correct, no? That's what it says. Okay, that's what that explanation given here. Then coming to very, very important part, parametric sensitivity analysis. Parameter, the sensitivity analysis, how far it is sensitive. Now that very, very important, as I told you, in DOE, we studied about input parameters and responses. Okay, that we have two component input parameters like rate of temperature, what you can say RPM like that, or concentration of the drugs like that, which can be dependent. We can able to change it. The next one is in response by observation of the analysis. We can able to do this data. If you could able to compare the data of a same study with the animal study, with the clinical study, even clinical study, if you say simple example like in clinical study, we could able to do it for pediatric, geriatric, adults, and males, females, 10 group of people, population. If you do the same study and compare the data, how far that particular drug behaves in different group of biological system, that comparative data of same, what you can say, input parameter and responses can be obtained by using a parametric sensitivity analysis. How far we can be able to do it. Now, this is a sensitivity analysis, very simple basic statistics. Everyone could be able to follow. Please do understand what is meant by sensitivity analysis. In parameter sensitivity analysis, different group of set of populations of same study can be comparative study. It's done by Gastro Plus. That's what we say. By performing a parametric sensitivity analysis, one parameter is changed gradually within the predicted range. No, that's what we used to say. OFAT, I used to say for DOE, one factor at a time, one factor at a parameter. That's what we used to say. Then we could able to explain by 3D surface graph. Then optimized design space function selected parameters can be useful tool. We'll say like down models. Here we can see like two, like drug absorb and Cmax. You can see here log input, concentrate, what you can say, what are the input parameters. Then we used to say Cmax. Here fraction of unabsorbed, we used to say, like if you say 100% is in standard value, then one formulation gives you some kind of data which you can say, this you can say sustained release dosage form. Then this one you say controlled release, maybe parenteral route. This one may be degraded, how much amount of drug is degrading. No, that's what we used to say. Here you can say same way. No, same, this is maybe predicted model or in vitro model. Then this is in pharmacokinetic model, maybe blood data, or this is in sustained release model. No, these three models can able to give the time at which reaches to the maximum, then we can say like degradation also. Same way, log input parameters, you can say here in other term, time, no, time in hour, drug particle radius. No, you can say this is a drug particle radius. You can say from here one we are getting, when you are increasing the particle size, drug particle, so radius, increasing the particle size, particle, drug particle size radius, no, the rate of absorption is observed. The drug particle density, we used to say it is lesser than particle size. Drug solubility, if solubility have more data for predictions, but solubility not having much data. Permeability, you can say like less. If you say here, this is in permeability, solubility, density, and radius. Out of that, what we can say, compared to all the four parameters of time to reach maximum for drug absorption, the drug particle have more effect or higher effect than particle size density, solubility, and permeability. That is what the parametric sensitivity analysis is giving. This is particle size, density, solubility, and permeability. No, this is better than this, this is better than this, this is better than this. Okay, that's what it says about again. Here you can say like it should not be more than 100. No, drug solubility, no, is better than drug dose, effective particle radius, particle size. Here if you say solubility character have more effect than what? Drug dose, effective drug particle size, density. Compared to density and solubility particle size, solubility have more effect on bioavailability. That's what it says about this model. Here you can able to see here, when particle size is smaller, no, when particle size smaller, bioavailability is more. No, this is 100%. Then particle size is bigger, that bioavailability is less. Then here if you say solubility, is solubility is lesser, no, solubility is lesser, then bioavailability is less. If solubility is more, bioavailability is more. That's what it says about this graph. No, thank you for listening. We can open for next immediately for next session. No, like now we'll have the discussion after this session.